Sam? Sam? Okay. north vegetation yet or not?
Possibly. Maybe. That looks like eelgrass, so I think there's eelgrass here now. And there's a side channel right below us. So this is actually
wetland vegetation
here
along the margins.
Down on.
A little bit of a cut bank there.
And it has no grass in it, especially at the lower end. Then there's some other weird green hook. Bright green. This is carrots. Sedges there. You can see the clumps of the different types of vegetation.
And if we could go just a little closer.
Eelgrass. Carrots meadow in front of the houses and the old pilings.
We could be section. This is riprap along the shoreline, but it's actually a bedrock natural cliff. So this is a road cut. Guys fishing all the way around. Here we've got cobble mixed in with riprap. And what they've done is blasted and such.
Huge old jetty.
We'll keep over towards the shore. Yeah, the mainstream will probably work along here. As we come along here, we do have riprap and landfill on the back shore, and then this is all riprap across here. You can see a little bit of a marsh there connected
that
with the culvert.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Looks like the browner material down below is Side of the coming up the sections which have been cleared at one time and for some reason not cleared, maybe they were pasture lands.
There's a really neat pattern here in the spit.
And a little bit of a headland here, lots of wood debris.
So we are approaching the entrance to the bay. Oh, this flag pole someone's put up there. So now you can see it's a mixture
big, steep
of cobbles and sand.
Wooded cliffs, trees falling in the water.
Places
looks
where
like
it's
carbon veneer all the way along.
Right
up a little bit of cliff
in
that
base
there.
Jetty.
That would pick up the breakwater. So there's a little indentation just inside the breakwater. And we'll continue on to the beach. And then we'll be jumping up to our next estuary
and
here.
It's
a very careful place, big rubble system. It's hugely armored. Just incredible, actually.
In the lower. Those are blades and threads, I think.
That's a Roger.
Threads and
We can see wood debris way back in the back shore there from older washover deposits and things like that.
Entrance,
so we've got washovers all the way back into the dunes
your
superstorms.
It's very lush. There's the,
and this would be a great shot looking along the beach towards Three Arches, I guess.
A low turf. Of reds. Wow, look at that pattern of the swash from the sand there. Unbelievable. And even more reds
close
there. Now I can see individual orange.
There may be some
stars,
of the biobanding there.
But overall, the jetty riprap looks quite bare.
Ready to zoom up to the next estuary, Sam? Okay, I'm going to stop filming here. And we're recording here.
Yeah,
that was really good. Whatever speed that was. Inside this estuary, we don't have any bird colonies or anything like that. Dead ahead.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any animals there, Mary.
And
looking around
the
beach, the name of this estuary again, Sam?
There's
a log
there.
The Helen River, and we're looking on the big spit. It's been deflected from north to south sediment transport. We've got riprap all along the shoreline here. This
beach.
Is great big rubble material. Powders all look good. We're about 27
riprap,
minutes into the tape
riprap
here.
Riprap with bare sand below it.
Swatch with a of eagle there, premature.
So the dune is, vegetation is a mixture
and now that the beach is narrowing here, we're losing kind of our active dune system. And we've got a beach face right across, much more well-defined. Here we've got a little bit of a scarp trees falling in, 30-meter wide, low-energy medium sand beach. And you can see the shoreline's actually eroding all along here. We've got tipped over trees. I actually don't see much of a scarp. There is a little scarp in the dunes in places. Here we've got a little wetland areas that looks like a freshwater pond in behind there. Shoreline.
It's a drip from up above over my head. What the? That would be a filamentous green.
And we've got actually light rain going on here, but
all
we're doing good back here.
Channel.
Land debris, 5 meters in width, a little bit of a scarp there, and then sort of a wide. Beach face area, you can see a number of swash lines. It's a lot of organic material on those beaches.
Swash lines there.
Some big trees, so stuff coming down the river here, creating a lot of interesting swash material, lots of organics and wood debris. No scarps in along here, although the storm load line is right up into the tree line there. Looks like some sort of kennel or something. Horse ring there.
Grass. Blah, 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 blah.
And a boat launching ramp. And underutilized campground today.
On this pier side.
Storm smash. We have tidal flats all down below us. And maybe when we get to this point up here, we'll kind of do a little bit of a pirouette. There's a little airstrip here. The airstrip.
A little riprap at the end of the strip.
Not sure why, but it's there. And then back into look like possibly older, really dune materials.
It looks like an old eroding dune there.
And Mike, before we start on this wetland shoreline, if we can just do a little pirouette here, a counterclockwise turn, and we'll shoot back, and then we'll get an overview of the estuary. It'd be great. Yep, just a tight little turn, it'd be great. And we're looking across the large white flats. Gonna do a little bit of a pirouette here. Look back at where we just filmed. We're looking across the spit. There's these big wide flats where we just came through. There's a wide channel, one center channel mainly, and looking out the river, and then we'll be just, that's good. And we're just looking up the river a ways. You can see the wetland shoreline with the flats down below. There's a little bit of wetland in here. Storm ash, there's a little bit of a berm and spit forming here, but storm logs up in behind. It's about 30, 40 meters. These logs, most of the cut logs are probably in the order of 10 meters in length, just for a scale. And we're just going around the fringing wetland in the upper intertidal here. There's great big flats out. That was what a pirouette was giving us before. And we've got logs right at the high water line. Going all the way from zero to about 5 meters in width.
And that's contrasting to this, that looks like a sedge.
Contrast between the different types of vegetation.
There's a
access there, down to the wetlands, lots of wood debris around the margins, and we're good with kind of rounding this corner here. There's a big distributary. There's logs all the way around the edges. I'd say about 5 meters in width.
Maybe.
And there's a great big log pile right up in the center frame there now. Another little estuary coming on the side. That one is 30 or 40 meters in width. And beautiful drainage pattern in the tidal marsh system. So the log debris pile.
Actually, I would like to do a pirouette just to the first channel there.
You can see the end of that log debris pile is right about in the center frame.
They're lying down in the marsh.
I'll zoom in on it. We got an opportunity to do that. I think I can. You can see how wide that is. I would say it's 30 meters in width in places there.
Yeah, that's good.
Then there's a great huge tree.
I wanted to get a really good example.
You can see where it's floated up, and there are some flat marks. There's the odd scar marks across the estuary.
Apparently, I'm interested in us going by.
Where you've had some
relaxing
things
in the carrots
scarred
there. That was good. Oh, you can see where they walked in. Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, so back over to the channel edge, I guess, and then up. And there's that low turf of the mysterious ground. Here it's joined by a low turf of greens with that pattern. Oh my gosh.
The marshes, beautiful coloration and different vegetation types. About 45 minutes into our tape, everything's looking good, sound looks good.
Filament to screen there. There's a big block of ducks below us. Not that big.
We'll just stay
maybe
on the main
50.
Channel here.
And some interesting
beautiful pattern in the vegetation. Sort of
there's a good view of the
across that upper tidal marsh.
Sedges.
Slightly different vegetation types.
Logs with stumps.
And lots of organic. This is all. Now you can see the wood debris. Looking up the channel, what we've got is kind of a mud sand flat, the main channel area. The bars in the channel are sandy. At the margins, you're getting a glistening coloration, indicating it's a mud primary matrix. Same with this little slough here, it's all mud in there.
The cut bank is.
And a little bit of a scarp on the outside. We've got some peat. Tipping in into the main channel here. You can just, even from way up here, we can smell the wood.
Yeah. How far up is are we supposed to go, Sam? Looks like it goes for a long way. Oh, fantastic view of the Carrick's type here.
It probably go slightly faster.
That's a big carrot.
And really tall grass here, all tipped over. Either that or there's been some animals foraging in there.
And look at all that wood hash.
We've got mud along the margins here. Lots of sticks.
Looks like sticks.
And wood debris along that margin. Kind of an eroding scarp here. You can see some of the peat is tipped in. As we fly by these little channels, I'll do a bit of zooming in there.
Exactly cutting away at the bank along the side.
And we've got a little training log coming up here. Looks like it's a pile, wood pile, training log. Looking up through
curious.
The channels, wetlands
now
around
it has
the edges.
A bit of a dike there,
and,
which has broken through here. And here,
and a again. Another little training row there.
Looks and a fantastic
Can we fly under? I have flown under the Golden Gate 3 times. That was in the old days. I think I'd be shot. We'd be shot down or something now. But
oh, look at there's a big
and they get Tacoma Narrows Bridge twice.
Big log accumulation there. That's just looking across at that where we circled where the
pilot
upward.
Was near retirement age, so he said sure. Along the margins
here, some landfill, the section.
I think this probably would have been bedrock, but it's
nice
been, you can see riprap along the shoreline in places.
It's
a little slough off to the side here, and now there's wetland around the margins, so that slough, I'm trying to get the inside of that. It looks like it's all wetlands. In around the margins, as far as I can see.
Oh yeah, look at all those old pilings all off, rotted off there.
Oh, I see, there's a whole channel in there.
Sedges. Now we're getting up into the freshwater dominated for sure. This is river zone.
Yeah.
I'm sure this is all tidally influenced.
Just a little leftward counterclockwise turn on. The mouth of this channel and I'll be able to shoot down it. And just coming up to the mouth of the side channel here, and mostly it's vegetation right up to the margins. We'll get a good longshore shot. This is probably as best we're going to get. Don't see any man-made shoreline in there. I think that's good. Generally, it doesn't look like it's an eroding shoreline. lines down below us.
And there, the lament is green under the power line crossing. Oh dear. Sorry about that. Oh, there's quite a few more pilings here. This looks like an old,
terrestrial stuff here.
Power lines there.
Those old pylons, there would have been some sort of pile supported structure there.
It's raining again. Yeah, that's pilings all along on the far side there.
And getting a bit of a shower.
Very pastoral.
I don't think any of this is tidal.
This is a side channel stream.
Getting a better image of the shoreline. It's pretty similar. It's sort of about a couple meter wide fringe. Side delta. No, I think we should fly back up. Yeah, if you could. And we're just catching, jumped off the margin there. We're into a shower here, but still imaging. Looks good overall.
Piled roadway. Went all along the sweep bank there. Just rows of pilings.
A little bit of a 2 meter wide, sort of sandy, muddy fringe below the terrestrial vegetation. That little river has a ditch, has all the wetland vegetation in it. Side of that channel, and it's you okay?
Yep.
And it's pretty much channelized here, a single channel, fairly deep. Terrestrial vegetation, and I think it's just natural riverbank, vegetated riverbank, so sort of raised stream deposits. And we've got a couple of side channels that we'll be going up. You can just see them at the top of the image. Man-made material just down below us with the roading
behind it,
and old oxbows and things cut through here. Those have been blocked off with a causeway.
Yeah.
Big old ship.
Debris and wood has accumulated by the pilings upstream.
Looks like
side
it's actually
bridge.
A small cutter dredge on the back of the ship.
And
actually a small dredge on the back of the ship there.
Cool.
And great imagery here as we come down the channel, lots of
worms
and things along the margins.
Over with Woody.
Just getting a lateral shot.
Got a dog there.
Sam, you wouldn't have a paper towel handy, would you? Each residence here has a small
docks in the
back. Do a little dabbing.
Yeah, built out. It's like a berry farm. This is modified and
this looks like mostly there is some landfill material and rubble along the road. There's riprap there. center frame. Very complicated shoreline in terms of man-made wharfs. Every single property has its own wharf. Back into farmland here with looks like old natural bank, vegetative bank, about a 2 or 3 meter wide fringe. And how far up this one are we going to go?
Still quite a bit of in-stream logs.
Okay. Stable to wetland bank. three or four meters of muddy sand material in the intertidal. And we're coming across the bridge.
And there's driftwood.
Whole accumulation of wood debris in there on top of the
so
wetland.
So this would be definitely tidal. This is salt marsh here.
They've constructed a dike. In the back shore, there's some wood debris up to that point. Some type of flood control gates there. Then we're going to have naturally wooded shoreline.
Putting over the bridge. And
wetland fringe there is. It's hard to say where the high water line is. I think it's where the water is just where the higher grass is. I can't see a swash line in there. Definitely the storm log line is right up the terrestrial vegetation base. This is a good chunk of that. A little bit of landfill behind there, just touching on the storm high water line. It's finish.
Even way up the toe of the beach there.
And this is just out in the mouth. We did a pirouette down here earlier. Around this corner where the trail line is in, it's a much more natural shoreline. Looks like coral pebble up intertidal, sand lower intertidal. You see the terrestrial vegetation creeping out. And now we're back into roadfill area along the tracks. Rubble along the shoreline. Pebble cobble boulder in the upper intertidal zone. Some of that's roadfill material that's come down, and then a sand flat down below that. And I think this sand flat is probably a pebble veneer. That's what's given the coloration on the flat. Beach face here, about 5 or 10 meters in width.
What's that guy doing down in the bushes there? His survey vest on.
On the beach face, as we're getting closer to the mouth here, we'll be getting higher energy. There's roadfill material. This is rubble from the train tracks.
Eelgrass below us. It's kind of clumpy, though.
My guess is that the track is not used very much anymore. Beach face here, pebble cobble veneer over sand. We got eelgrass down below. Back into wetlands, pebble cobble boulder veneer over sand. There's shell on the beach, getting all kinds of warning signs here from our tapes. But we've just got about a minute to go if we can just make it. This is pebble cobble veneer, beach face. There's boulders on the beach. This looks like some type of low industrial site. It's been converted into a recreational site. Lots of slips here. That's our landfill across the beach. Pebble cobble veneer, pebble veneer over the beach. This is all riprap around the edges where we've had the landfill. Sort of a boat launching ramp in behind there. Here we've got
filamentous green, there's the rail bridge again.
And just a little bit further.
Filamentous green and mucus is the dominant here. Look at that. Yay!
You can see back of this bedrock there. There's some big, huge chunks. This is riprap now. Now we're in the whole section of riprap shoreline. Not sure if this is part of the drainage system or just to protect the road. This is a natural cliff section in here. Pebble cobble veneer over sand on those beaches. And now we're into the main riprap area from the at the mouth of the estuary here.
And it's right beside
and here we've got a little beach system and lagoon system in behind the breakwater. There's a low part of the breakwater there that will allow wash through. And this is a higher part of the rubble breakwater at the mouth here. And just a little bit further. And we'll be good.
A lot of driftwood in the upper part there. And then out to the sand dunes again. This is all incredible sand dunes.
I'm just looking down there, just going out, and I'm going to stop filming right here. I'm going to stop filming right here, and we can head back, and we've got one little stretch to do in Tillamook on the way back, right towards the airport.